Looking at the past, looking in the future, but being present in the now as well is what is coming in. Hello, Pisces. Welcome, new viewers, cross watchers, and my lovely, lovely moonians. This is a monthly reading for July 2020. We will be looking into love and anything else that the spirit has for us. All right? So we are in a period of a lot of retrogrades. So take it easy is something which I'd like to say. The first card coming through as an energy indicator is action coming in reverse, which is in a way talking about first seeking the guidance of your higher self and then taking an action. So maybe you are thinking of making a decision just yet, maybe driven by the emotions that you have been feeling of late, but this may be saying that, like, you know, if you feel that there is a lack of information right now, you may like to utilize your intuition for that additional information, but this may not really be the time to take action just yet. Time to consider everything. Divine feminine energy which is coming through, but let's not get impulsive. We have victory also coming in reverse, which is again signifying the fact that, like, you know, you need to first believe in yourself. This is someone who is closing off his or her opportunities for the fact that they may be thinking about something negative or focusing on the pessimistic outcome. That is the energy which is coming in. If it's not even that, I'm just saying there are two ways of looking at something. Maybe you are very much aware of one side of looking at it, but the other side is also very essential to take into consideration, something like pros and cons kind of a thing, before making a judgment, before making a life-changing decision. That is the energy which is coming in. So I feel like in a way this is saying we may like to refine, retune our goals, our approach. In a way is the energy which is coming in. Better be preventive than look out for reinforcement or something which saves you while you are taking action. That is what is coming in. Strategizing is the energy which is coming through. We have envy coming in, which is telling you, let's not compare our life, our growth, our success to others, of that of others, because it will only limit your potential to theirs, is something which is coming in. So while someone may be feeling like, you know, I can't take a decision, but at the very same time comparing other people being happy perhaps, or the kind of success that they are enjoying at the moment, and getting a little sabotaged due to that, is what is coming through. And we have man holding a coin coming in reverse, which may be indicating this may not really be the time to make a financial move or investment or speculative investments and all of that. Be away from that. It could be like, you know, this person, when this comes in reverse, someone comes in with a very good idea, solution, approach to something or a scheme. They will really try to sell it to you, but may not acquire certain kind of assets on their own. Like, they'll be recommending it to you, but they may not, if you ask them personally, they may not go for it. Kind of an energy does come in. So just be aware of your finances and who are you lending money to is also what is coming in. And this person over here, like, if you split this into two, there's a little bit of underconfidence which is coming in. A little too much focus on the financial constraint that one may be feeling is also what is coming in. And getting a little envious of other people's inflow, cash flow. We have rest and rejuvenation coming in, stressing too much that we need to remember to breathe, which is coming through. Walking away, there's something which still needs to be let go of. This is again talking about that you are ready now to let go, release, walk away from an association or a hurt of the past which has been stopping you. And this is again talking about there are two choices right now. Something of the past, the way we have been doing things, and something in regards to the future which is really good for you, but something is stopping you from walking in that positive direction. What is it? Is it something which is internal, or is it something environmental around you, external? We have goddess of the moon also coming in reverse, which is talking about a lack of utilization of your intuition or their intuition. Someone who is not really connecting with their emotional world because they are too concerned about the outside world, comparing where they are with others, getting or focusing on the lack and not really realizing how much potential this person has. Only and if only they realize that right now, no one else is the opponent but their own self. They are their own opponent at the moment. Getting limited by expectation is also something which is coming in. And this one also talks about choosing to think positively, choosing a positive path, realizing where you are, what needs to go, because it is coming in, it will keep on coming in till the time you haven't released it properly, fully. There is certain kind of ending a chapter before you can start anew, certain kind of change which is required before starting anew, before the initiation comes in. So let's not make hasty decisions just yet. Be more wary of what you have created in your life, relationship, financially as well, business-wise as well. Be more aware of that is also what is coming in. Be a little protective of what you have built, put in so much effort towards building. That is something which is coming through. Finding value where you are, being grateful for the blessings that you have already, all the things which are around you, your loved ones, and all of that is also what is coming in. Let's not compare ourselves to others. What good does that bring? Alright, so let's go forward looking into the clarifiers. Before we go into that, I just feel that there's a very strong need for you to connect with your higher self, because the ego self or the 3D self is speaking too loudly and certain things are turning into negative inner saboteur. And that is stopping you, limiting your point of view also perhaps, but stopping you from doing what is right for you. Because there's something, some unfinished business which keeps on lingering on and weighing you down. Become aware of that. As a clarifier, we have messenger of earth coming in, which is talking about making promises, getting motivated, wanting to learn more kind of energy, apprentice kind of energy which is coming in. So it could also be one thing which just channeled in was, this may be a time wherein you may be feeling confused and you may like to be a little open to the suggestions which may be coming in. Don't take the feedback too personally. It's someone's point of view. Doesn't mean it defines you. But yes, if there is something and you realize, yeah, I can work upon that, then why not take it into consideration? And when you have all the inputs coming in, come up with a creative resolution which is in sync with you and not pushed or coerced upon you. That is what is coming in. Do what is right for you. Don't get pushed, agitated by the timeline is also what is coming in. We have a plan that's impeccable. That's very good. Like, you know, I highly support following through a plan. But when you fixate it with time, it sometimes limits us from fully enjoying the flexible journey of it. I'm just losing track of what I'm saying, but it's just like being a little flexible with your plans, the element of surprise, welcoming it. And I'm not saying, like, you know, you have to completely let go of the ego self. It is very important because it makes us anxious and, like, you know, become very aware, self-preservative as well, which is very much required. But it's just that make sure that the ego or the guilt is not limiting you from fully experiencing life or advancing towards a more meaningful life, all right? And we have the Hermit card also coming in, Virgo Major Arcana coming through again with the rest and rejuvenation energy. And the Hermit over here could be that this person is going through a spiritual transformation or stepping into the spiritual journey. And at first, it becomes very tough to disassociate yourself from the 3D realm, which is why we have so much energy, a little bit of low vibrational energy, or a little too much concern about the world which is coming through over here. They have to let go of that. And again, we have a 9 coming in. 27, when we add it together, we have 9 which comes through, certain kind of ending which is very much required, which will allow regeneration and rebirth of certain kind before anything starts off. Realizing where you are, acknowledging and releasing, amending, taking actions accordingly, small baby steps, one day at a time kind of energy which is coming in. You have a foresight, that's great. But make sure that you also have short-term goals so that the journey of achieving them gives you more satisfaction and not simply just give up saying, oh, this is just not going to happen. I've given enough time for it, but it's just not happening. Of course it can happen. Believe in yourself. Continue. Sometimes it is very hard to continue doing what you're doing, especially if you're healing. It's not easy. Everyone talks about it and like, you know, I have healed and everything. But the moment you start healing, there's so many other things which just come rushing back to you. And sometimes it can be suffocating. So I am with you, supporting you, whatever you're doing, continue. All right? Let's look into the oracle which is coming in, certain kind of guidance which may be there. Thank you. We have yang energy coming in a way in reverse, which is again talking about take small steps, make smart choices for you, all right? And yang energy in itself talks about action, but also again, when it is coming in reverse, it could be signifying a wounded divine masculine energy. When it is wounded, when the divine masculine energy, yang, talks about action, the fire in the belly, creativity as well, but more of like dealing with the world. So when this comes, someone is wounded, their divine masculine is wounded, they tend to become very limited, they are underconfident, they can be very impulsive, irritated, dominating as well, because there's certain kind of satisfaction that they get from dominating the other person, having their way, because somewhere down the line when they step into the world, they feel a very underconfident, so their outlet comes on the other person kind of a thing. And at the very crux of it, there's certain kind of self-belief which is very much required, retreating from the society which is very much required, to really realize what is of value. What have I been overly pursuing? Why am I feeling impatient? Why am I feeling lost? And why is there an anger behind that anger? Where did that stem from? Someone requires the time to really look at their own actions at the moment is what's coming through. We have cleaned it up. Whatever mess that we are making, someone is making due to impulsiveness, short temper and all of that, they need to amend things up. Also with the cleanup, this also in a way is telling me, become aware of the clogging energy, clogged up things, anxiety, stress, low vibrational energies or energy vampires that may be in your vicinity. Release that. It is time to breathe. Maybe to feel better, you could be feeling stagnant energy in your life, like quite physically as well. So maybe shifting around a few things in your house, in your space, will be very, very beneficial to activate the environment a little, is also what is coming in. And we have the tribe also coming through. Community kind of energy which is coming in. And this is talking about a little influence. See, I have to step into many things, but I will. We had someone, a potential someone, who didn't have true intention, or even if they did, they had certain kind of misleading information. With the tribe coming in, this person really needs to become aware of who is their true friend. And this may be a time where they are realizing that they have had quite a few toxic people in their life, and they may be transforming, and with that their friend circle could also be changing. And all that transition takes time to get accustomed to. So could be like, you know, they are getting a reality check of certain things, and it's in regards to something which they were very, very sure shot of. And they highly relied on certain people who right now, with the lockdown and everything, they're getting to see their real side of who their friend really is. And it can be quite troublesome, quite hurtful to really look at someone's true side, true nature, true intention. Give them the time to understand what is going on, because for this person, it could be like, you know, they're going through a revelation, and sometimes it can be very, very uncomfortable as well, especially if someone has been in their comfort zone, building up a life, wanting change but not quite doing it themselves. And then these sudden exits, sudden realization, reality check come in, and a storm comes through, and some people just think, what hit me? Where did this come from? Not realizing that it was always there, the red flags were there, and they just didn't pay much attention to it, is also what is coming in, which is why we had the goddess of the moon, the psychic energy, which was coming in. Of course, these are just channeled energy which are coming in, and I'm just tapping into it. So let's see any kind of messenger which is coming in. Thank you so much. We have humanity and benevolence with faith. Stay calm, trust in the good in yourself and others, see the light in the world which is coming in. This may be a time to really, like, you know, with the spirituality, tap into your altered state, do some meditation as well, breath work if you feel anxious, and cut the trigger point by focusing on your breath for a little while. And so way too many, but we'll go into it. Do good for those who deserve your effort, who are worth it, is also what is coming in. We have holy amethyst, divine alchemy coming in. Move beyond current challenges. Focus on what you desire. Very essential. Like, there could be daily worries and everything, anxiety which is coming in. At the end of it, what is your dream? What are your aspirations? And what are you doing today to go a step closer to that waking reality? We have Commander Ashtar, call to action. Take charge, lead by example, walk your talk. Only talking and promising is not going to help, but your actions also should be matching up to your words, is what is coming in. So become aware of that. It's the same with this person, man holding a coin, also promising of the fruition or the abundance which this thing, certain aspect, venture will get you, but not really, but things don't add up, kind of a thing. A little bit of discernment also, which is coming in a little on your behalf, especially if you're planning to do something. Take your time, take small actions which are in your control, is also what is coming through. Just don't stagnate your life. Mary Magdalene is coming in. Teacher awakens. You have something important to share. Follow the inner call. Don't let anything stop you, especially your own negative inner saboteur. We have Horus also coming in. Cosmic gateway. Your thoughts are magnetic and powerful. Miraculous changes are occurring. So yeah, could be like, you know, this is a transformative time, and certain things which are built on faulty grounds, whose foundation wasn't strong enough, will be leveling up for you to build upon stronger foundation. Something more realistic, something more meaningful to come through. And all of this is just saying follow your inner voice. Apart from that, this is also saying there's a beautiful cosmic gateway which is opening up. There's a lot of divine feminine, divine masculine balancing, which is very important. Apart from that, realizing who you really are, your own power, and listening to your higher self, inner voice, because the moment you start building that rapport up with your higher self, there will be many other synchronicities, messages, wisdom which will be coming in many different ways, is what I'm seeing over here. This is a time where you can balance your connection with 3D realm and the sacred realm as well, and it will be very, very beneficial for you. I feel as though your spiritual fire is growing, and you have to recognize that the power of your soul is more and greater than you think you know. It's also what is coming in, really realizing who you really are. That kind of energy is coming in. Let's look into the clarifiers. These are way too many. At the bottom we have Two of Winters, and at top we have Renewal. Very interesting, because the thing which I said about coming out with creative resolutions, review the past and the present so you can plant a bright new future, understanding your life purpose, releasing judgment of yourself and others also, which is coming in. And when you see this one, the description for this one is again like, you know, coming up with creative resolutions also, looking at the past, looking in the future, but being present in the now as well is what is coming in, to make best use of the opportunities that are with you. We have Nine of Springs. I was talking about being protective of what you have built, and this energy says that. Prepare for possible challenges that lie ahead, environmental conservation, protect the fruits of your labors. We have Ace of Summers coming in, and the way my throat is also catching up, like, you know, just have a heart-to-heart conversation. When you speak, speak clearly. Take your time. Don't rush into retaliating or saying something hurtful because you feel hurt. This is a time where Mercury is in retrograde, so communication is a little awry. So be aware of that is also what I'm saying. Seeing over here, Ace of Summers is a new initiation of love. But this is also saying it is now time to open to true love, which may be in front of you, but due to the veil or illusion of the past, or fear or distrust, it is stopping you from fully experiencing this opportunity which lies ahead of you. We have Seven of Springs, again about communication. Be assertive, don't back down from what you believe, courageously stand up for yourself. We have Unity also coming in. Do the right thing for the right reason. Compare traditional versus new approaches to see which works for you. A spiritually minded community which will be coming in. But right now you have to become aware of all those things which are stopping you. Toxic, low vibrational energy, people who may be influencing you. We have the Leo Major Arcana, the Sun, also coming in. Reassuring you that your plans will be working out perfectly. Gratitude for the blessings of life and success which will be coming in. So don't worry about that. And with the Queen of Autumn coming through, I was just looking into the picture. Again, see if you can see her eyes are closed, just like the Victory energy card which came through first. Believing in yourself is very much required. Look at things practically as well. Express yourself gracefully is something which is coming in. We have Seven of Summers talking about certain kind of procrastination which is going on because someone may be over analyzing something a little too much. We have Ten of Springs coming in. Ask for help from others. All work, no play. Being weighed down by too many responsibilities. Free up your space. We have King of Autumn also coming in, who is compassionate, accomplished, charismatic, gifted. Be assertive. Being assertive is coming in twice now. When it comes to what you know is right, everything going your way, a good person or company to work for is also what is coming in. So financially things will be getting better, recognition which will be coming in. And financially I don't really see too much happening, but just make sure that you're not overly scheduling yourself, that you don't get time to spend time alone, in reflection, or just relaxing. Make sure that you're taking time to rest and rejuvenate. It's very much important. As much it is important to take action, it is also important to retrieve, look at things, reassess, and then go forward. And at the end of it, be assertive, be clear, clearly communicate what you really want, and don't hit around the bushes. And apart from that, like you have to be assertive, but make sure the way that you're speaking is graceful, respectful to yourself and the other person as well, and filled with compassion. And when you speak, be open to listen to the other person as well, and not just persistent or inclined on putting your point forward only. All right, that is what is coming in. And just don't take everything personally. It may be like, you know, we may be in a moment where this person has a different intention of saying something to you, but it comes out differently to you. So don't react impulsively just in that moment. Give it some time before you speak, so that the impact of your words is much, much better, and in a way welcomed as well. This again is in a way talking about the way you are communicating. So not only to other people, but to the universe as well. And thoughts, become aware of your thoughts. Negative thoughts, low vibrational thoughts will be bringing in the similar energies into your life, similar situations which bring the same wave of that energy. So become aware, become smart the way that you're thinking, because you're attracting a similar energy into your life. Alright, so do let me know if this resonated with you. And I feel this was a very long reading. It feels like that because I feel this month will be a time where you will be able to review, if you have the patience of doing that. Some inner work is also very much essential, because there's some weight which we have been carrying forward for a very, very long time. Each month it comes through. It's time to let go and to welcome something new. Alright, so do let me know, and thank you so much for being part of the Moon Yin family. If you aren't already, then please do subscribe, share it with the loved ones, comment below and hit the like. Until next time, love, light, empowerment, clarity, assertiveness, and all the most strength to you all. Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely Moon Yins.